Spinal muscular atrophy is a genetic disorder characterized by weakness and wasting in muscles used for movement. Ndopu was diagnosed with the condition in 1992.
My doctors predicted that I wouldn't live beyond the age of 5. Next year, in the same year that we observe the 30th anniversary of Namibia's independence, I will be turning 30 years old as well. Outliving myself by 25 years.
To date, Ndopu has achieved so much more and has become a beacon of hope for many people with disabilities around the world. He was recently appointed as an advisor to the United Nations Office on Issues of Disability.
I want to demonstrate to children with disabilities, using my life as a point of reference, that they can grow up to become protagonists in the story of their own lives, that they themselves are the ones that they have been waiting for.
Ndopu also worked for leading organizations such as the World Economic Forum, UN Women, and Amnesty International. Last year, he graduated from Oxford University with a master's in public policy and became one of the first African disabled person to achieve this.
I am deeply passionate about ensuring that the needs and the aspirations of the most vulnerable and neglected segments of society are reflected in all of the SDGs, so that the agenda in its entirety speaks to everybody equally.
Ndopu revealed that he is soon expected to make history of being the first physically disabled person to travel into space and to deliver a televised address to the United Nations to create awareness surrounding the Sustainable Development Goals.
Just an adventure, this voyage will be my love letter to the enduring power of the human spirit. Because it is the enduring power of the human spirit that enables us to overcome tremendous odds and embody the existential defiance that is required for us to navigate the existential crises that we as humanity currently face.
Ndopu attributes his growth and expansion to his experiences and exposure he gained from the African Leadership Academy. The young men inspired members of the Children's Parliament and made various contributions during their sessions. Evelyn Paulus, NBC News, Vancouver.